Today we're going to be taking a look at a broadcast quality monitor. This monitor is from Marshall Electronics, and you can adjust it so that you can get accurate color in your productions. So your first step is to generate some bars, and you can do this with your camera, or you can do it with your NLE. Look inside of your instruction manual on your camera, and you can see if it has bars. I'm using Final Cut Pro here to generate those bars. Now the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to change the monitor into mono mode, so this gives me this black and white mode, and we're going to adjust the brightness. So with this monitor, I start at about 50% and I start to take it down, and then I start to bring it up. And what we're looking for is down in the bottom right in the plunge, we're looking for this little black bar right here, and we want to turn down the brightness until it just about goes away. You want to barely make it visible. And it's hard to see it on this monitor because we're shooting it with a camera, so we have a couple variables here. So I'm going to show you in the simulation just what it would look like in Final Cut Pro. So again, down in the plunge, down in the bottom right, you're looking for that little one black bar, and you barely want to make it visible, just one tick away from it being visible, and that will give you your accurate setting for brightness. The next one that we're going to take a look at is adjusting the contrast. And when we adjust the contrast, we're starting again at 50%, we're taking it down until we see full black, and then we'll take it up until we see full white. The white should just be totally blooming out. And what we're looking for is an even gradation all the way across the board. So here in the simulation mode, you can see what happens is we turn it all the way up, all the way down, and then we're going to try and get a nice even 80% gray for the white. And the next thing we're going to do is we're going to adjust the color. So we're going to go into blue mode. This is a unique feature that's on this monitor and most professional broadcast monitors. And what we're looking to do here is turn our color until we can get the long bar to be totally even on both the left and the right. Let's take a look at the simulation. So again, that little tiny bar down in the bottom right, we want to become equal. One of the things that you're going to see here is just what a proper set of bars should look like. So this is what they look like, and let's jump back over to these features. So down here you can see the F1, F2, F3, F4. Now these are presets unique to this monitor. We can go in and adjust things like freeze input. This is really helpful if you're shooting in a wide shot and then you want to go in and get your close-up. You can freeze your wide shot and then see what your hands look like, and then you can go in and make sure that your hands are holding the same object the same way. Another cool feature that you might be interested in knowing about is the fact that this one has a 1:1 pixel mapping, so basically it zooms in and it doesn't scale the image, so you're able to see a very zoomed in looking image, and this can help you with focus. Another cool feature is something here called red peaking. This puts a nice little sharp red line around areas that are in focus. So as we start to move into focus, you're going to see the red develop around the edges. Very cool feature for adjusting focus. And you can use both 1:1 and the peaking at the same time. Kind of cool. I've got that set up on a preset. One more feature that's pretty unique to this monitor is something called false color. And you'll want to look at the instruction manual and see how to read false color, but basically it's telling you that this little pink area right here is what flesh tone should be exposed to. This will just help you adjusting your iris as you're opening up, or if you're turning it down, you're basically trying to stay away from things looking really fuchsia or looking too red or too yellow. So again, this false color is going to allow you to adjust your exposure until you get good skin tones, and it's very helpful. Another cool feature of this monitor is just its sheer size. It's got a great viewing angle, and you can put it on top of your camcorder. I like to use it with an Israeli arm so I can angle it wherever I want. And it's especially helpful when I'm shooting from the hip or on the ground. This one's got an HDMI input as well as component inputs. You can order them with HDSDI as well, or just analog component only. It does standard F2. You can also see that you can power the unit with a slimline battery from Sony, or you can use a variety of other battery plates from other manufacturers such as Panasonic, JVC, and Canon, or you can use IDX batteries or Anton Bauer's. So thanks for watching this episode, and I'll catch you later.